हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अवर रोज प्रोजेक्ट। माई सेल्फ पाटिल वी एस फ्रॉम एजीएम कॉलेज कराड। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एल्डिहाइड एंड कीटोन्स। नाउ इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द रिमेनिंग प्रिपरेशन मेथड्स ऑफ एल्डिहाइड, कीटोन एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड। नाउ फर्स्ट वी विल सी द लास्ट प्रिपरेशन मेथड ऑफ एल्डिहाइड एंड कीटोन, that is fifth preparation method, preparation of aldehyde only from esters. In this preparation method, esters are reduced by using diisobutyl aluminium hydride and then it gives the aldehyde. The reaction is usually carried out at 195 Kelvin to prevent further reduction of aldehyde. In this reaction, this is ester group, that is R C double bond O O R. This ester are reduced by using diisobutyl aluminium hydride, or this is also written as ALH, here I, here BU, instead of BR here BU, and twice means diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Means this esters are reduced by using diisobutyl aluminium hydride, then this gives aldehyde. In this reaction, two hydrogen atoms are used to reduce this ester. Here R C double bond O, one of the hydrogen atom is attached to this carbon atom to give here aldehyde, that is R C double bond O H, and this OR group is converted to alcohol group. Means here hydrogen atom is attached to this oxygen atom to give here R dash OH, means alcohol. See example, this is the CH3 C double bond O OCH3. In this case, this is the formula of methyl acetate. This methyl acetate reduced with diisobutyl aluminium hydride, then reduction means addition of hydrogen atom. Here two hydrogen atoms are added to this methyl acetate. Here this CO bond breaks and hydrogen atom is attached to this carbon atom to give here acetaldehyde, that is the CH3 C double bond O and H CH3 CHO. And another hydrogen atom is attached to this oxygen atom, then this OR group is converted to alcohol group, that is a methyl alcohol. Means this methyl acetate are reduced by using diisobutyl aluminium hydride, then it gives acetaldehyde and methyl alcohol. Then next point is preparation of carboxylic acid. In this preparation of carboxylic acid, first preparation method is from nitriles and amides. In this reaction, alkyl nitrile or aryl nitriles on acid hydrolysis, then this gives amides. And these amides on further acid hydrolysis gives corresponding carboxylic acid. Here hydrolysis is carried out by using dilute HCl. See general reaction, here R C triple bond N, means this is alkane nitrile, or this is also known as alkyl nitrile or aryl nitrile. This alkane nitrile or aryl nitrile on acid hydrolysis. Acid hydrolysis means in presence of acid, here H2O molecule is added to this aryl nitrile. Then this gives intermediate product, that is unstable compound. Here OH group is attached to this carbon atom, then this gives RCOH. Then this triple bond is converted to double bond and hydrogen atom is attached to this nitrogen atom to give here RCOH double bond NH, because the valency of carbon is 4. And this unstable compound on rearrangement means here this hydrogen atom is shifted towards this nitrogen atom to give here NH2, and this double bond is transferred in between this carbon oxygen atom to give carbon oxygen double bond, means this RC double bond O NH2, and this is known as amide. Then this amide on acid hydrolysis means in presence of acid, Here water molecule is added, then this gives here carboxylic acid. In this reaction, this RC double bond O and this OH is attached to this carbon atom to give RCOOH, that is carboxylic acid. And this NH2, these two hydrogen atoms, that is NH4 and this Cl gives NH4Cl. Means here amide on acid hydrolysis, this gives carboxylic acid, that is RCOOH. Then this reaction also takes place in single equation, that is this alkyl nitrile on acid hydrolysis, here two molecules of water added to this nitrile, then this gives carboxylic acid and NH4Cl. Here RC triple bond N, here oxygen atom is attached to this carbon atom to give RC double bond O, and OH group is attached to this carbon atom, means RCOOH, that is carboxylic acid. Then this N and here these three hydrogen atoms and this one hydrogen, means total four hydrogen atoms and one nitrogen, gives NH4Cl. And this alkyl nitrile on acid hydrolysis, this gives carboxylic acid. See example. Here ethane nitrile, or this is also known as methyl cyanide, on acid hydrolysis, then this gives ethanoic acid, or this is also known as acetic acid. In this reaction, here two molecules of water added to this methyl cyanide. Here CH3C, this oxygen is attached to this carbon atom to give CO, and OH group is attached to this carbon atom, then this gives CH3COOH, means acetic acid or ethanoic acid. Then this nitrogen atom and remaining three hydrogen atoms, means NH3, and this H means NH4Cl. This is a byproduct, means here it gives, that is ethanoic acid. Then see second preparation method from acyl chloride and anhydride. In this reaction, acyl chloride on hydrolysis with water, then this gives carboxylic acid. See example, here RCOCl means acyl chloride on hydrolysis with water, then this gives carboxylic acid and HCl. Here this Cl and this H gives HCl, here HCl, and OH group is attached to this carbon atom to give RCO and OH, means carboxylic acid. Then see example, here CH3COCl, means this is known as acetyl chloride. This acetyl chloride on hydrolysis with water, then this gives acetic acid. In this reaction, this H and Cl reacts with each other to give here HCl. And OH group is attached to this carbon atom, then this gives CH3COOH, that is acetic acid. Means acetyl chloride on hydrolysis with water, then this gives acetic acid, that is carboxylic acid, known as ethanoic acid. Then in case of anhydride, here anhydride on hydrolysis with water, then this gives carboxylic acid. Here anhydride formula is RC double bond O, O, C double bond O, R. Hydrolysis, here water molecule is added to this anhydride, then this gives, here RCO, O and this H gives RCOOH. Then this R, then this C, O and OH gives RCOOH, means two molecules of carboxylic acid are formed. Then see third preparation method, that is from ester by hydrolysis. In this ester, these esters undergo hydrolysis in two ways, that is acid hydrolysis of ester. In case of acid hydrolysis, here esters on hydrolysis with the dilute mineral acid like dilute HCl or dilute H2SO4, then this gives corresponding carboxylic acid. Here this is ester RCOO R dash plus H2O in presence of dilute H2SO4. Then these esters on hydrolysis with dilute H2SO4, then this gives corresponding carboxylic acid. Here H2O molecule is added to this ester, then this gives here RCO. Here bond breaking takes place, here bond breaks, then RCO, and OH group is attached to this carbon atom, then this gives RC double bond OOH, that is carboxylic acid. And this OR is converted to alcohol, that is R dash OH. Then see example, here CH3COOCH3. This ester, that is a methyl acetate, on hydrolysis with dilute sulfuric acid. Hydrolysis in presence of acid, then water molecule is added to this methyl acetate, then this gives acetic acid. In this case, here CH3CO and this OH is attached to this carbon atom to give CH3COOH, means acetic acid. And this OR group, means CH3O group, is replaced by alcohol group, that is CH3O, and this H gives CH3OH, that is methyl alcohol. Means this methyl acetate on hydrolysis with dilute mineral acid to give acetic acid. The next example is methyl benzoate. This is the formula of methyl benzoate, C6H5COOCH3. This methyl benzoate on hydrolysis with dilute mineral acid like dilute H2SO4, then this gives benzoic acid. In this reaction, here bond breaks and this CH3O group is converted to alcohol group, that is CH3OH. Means hydrogen atom is attached to this oxygen atom to give CH3OH. And this C6H5CO and OH group is attached to this carbon atom to give C6H5COOH. Means benzoic acid. This is acid hydrolysis. Because in this reaction takes place in presence of acid, that is H2SO4, and therefore the name, that is acid hydrolysis. Then second, that is alkaline hydrolysis of ester. In case of alkaline hydrolysis of ester, here when an ester is heated with alkali like NaOH or KOH, then it gives sodium or potassium salts of carboxylic acid. And this on acidification with concentrated HCl, then this gives acid. In this reaction, here C2H5, C double bond O, OCH3. This is known as methyl propanoate. This methyl propanoate is heated with alkali like NaOH. Then this gives sodium propanoate. In this reaction, here bond breaks. Here this bond breaks and ONA group is attached to this carbon atom. Then this gives C2H5, C double bond O, and this ONA is attached to this carbon atom, means C2H5, C double bond O, ONA. This is known as sodium propanoate. And this methyl group, that is CH3, this O, and this hydrogen, means hydrogen atom is attached to this oxygen atom to give OH, and we get here alcohol, that is a methyl alcohol. Then this sodium propanoate on acid hydrolysis in presence of concentrated HCl, water molecule is added to this sodium propanoate, then this gives propanoic acid. In this reaction, here this Na and OH gives NaOH, and the remaining hydrogen atom is attached to this oxygen atom to give C2H5C double bond OOH, that is a propanoic acid. Here the sodium or potassium salts of higher fatty acid are known as soaps. And the alkaline hydrolysis of esters is called as saponification. See here, fourth preparation method, that is from alkyl benzene. In this alkyl benzene, aromatic carboxylic acids can be prepared by oxidation of alkyl benzene with dilute HNO3 or alkaline or acidic KMnO4 or chromic acid. In this reaction, this is alkyl benzene, that is methyl benzene, or this is known as toluene. This toluene, on oxidation with alkaline KMnO4, alkaline KMnO4 means KMnO4 and KOH. Then this alkaline KMnO4 oxidizes this methyl benzene to give here potassium benzoate. And this potassium benzoate on acid hydrolysis means in presence of acid, your water molecule is added to this potassium benzoate to give benzoic acid. In this reaction, here three nascent oxygens are used as for the oxidation of this toluene. Then this gives potassium benzoate, and this on acidification or this on acid hydrolysis, then this gives benzoic acid. Then see next example. Here this is known as isopropyl benzene, that is CH3CH CH3. This group is attached to this benzene ring. This is known as a cumene or isopropyl benzene. This isopropyl benzene on oxidation with alkaline KMnO4, then this gives potassium benzoate, that is C6H5COOK. And this potassium benzoate on acid hydrolysis, then this gives benzoic acid. In this reaction, here this hydrogen atom, या रिएक्शन मध्ये काय पाहिजे, एक तरी बेंझिलिक हायड्रोजन ऍटम हा अटॅच असला पाहिजे, तरच त्यापासून आपल्याला काय मिळणार आहे, बेंझोइक ऍसिड. हियर दिस कार्बन चेन इज थ्री कार्बन ऍटम्स चेन, CH3CCH3. मीन्स ही जर कार्बन ऍटम, 10 कार्बन ऍटमची जरी चेन असली तरी त्या ठिकाणी आपल्याला एक तरी बेंझिलिक हायड्रोजन ऍटम हा अटॅच असला पाहिजे, तरच त्या ठिकाणी काय मिळणार आहे, बेंझोइक ऍसिड मिळणार आहे. जर या रिएक्शन मध्ये इथं टर्शरी कार्बन ऍटम असता, म्हणजे CH3CCH3 या एचच्या ऐवजी जर CH3 असता, तर या ठिकाणी बेंझोइक ऍसिड मिळत नाही. इथं एक तरी बेंझिलिक हायड्रोजन ऍटम हा अटॅच असलाच पाहिजे, तरच या ठिकाणी काय मिळतं, बेंझोइक ऍसिड मिळतं. या रिएक्शन मध्ये दिस इज 1 2 3 हायड्रोजन ऍटम्स आर अटॅच टू दिस कार्बन ऍटम, म्हणजे या ठिकाणी तीन बेंझिलिक हायड्रोजन ऍटम्स आहेत, म्हणून काय तयार होतं, बेंझोइक ऍसिड तयार होतं. The next reaction is from alkene by oxidation. In this reaction, when carboxylic acid, this is a carboxylic acid, can be prepared by the oxidation of phenyl ethene by KMnO4 in dilute H2SO4, then this gives benzoic acid. This is known as phenyl ethene because this is CH2 double bond CH2. Hydrogen atom is replaced by this phenyl group. This is alkene because here double bond. Therefore, name of this compound is phenyl ethene. And this phenyl ethene on oxidation with KMnO4 and dilute H2SO4. That time, here 5 nascent oxygen atoms are added to this phenyl ethene. Then this gives here benzoic acid. Here 2 oxygen atoms, nascent oxygen atoms, are attached to this carbon atom. Then this gives C6H5COONH. This is a benzoic acid. Then this carbon atom and the remaining 2 oxygen atoms gives carbon dioxide. Then this H2 and O gives H2O. Means here 5 nascent oxygens are used to this oxidize to this phenyl ethene, that is this 2 oxygen, 2 plus 2, 4, and this 5th oxygen atoms are added to this phenyl ethene to give here benzoic acid. Then see cyclohexene on oxidation with the KMnO4 and dilute H2SO4 to give adipic acid. This is the cyclohexene, means here CH, CH2, 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 CH. Means cyclohexene on oxidation with KMnO4 and dilute H2SO4 to give here adipic acid. Here in this reaction, this bond breaks and we get here this CH, your C and two oxygen atoms are attached to this carbon atom, then this gives COOH, and this CH and two oxygen atoms are added to this carbon atom to give COOH. This is known as adipic acid. Here this is carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Total 6 carbon atoms are present. Therefore, this is the derivative of hexane. From first carbon atom, here this is the carbon number 1. Here this is carbon number 1 and carbon number 6. 1,6 dioic acid means name of this compound also hexane 1,6 dioic acid. Means cyclohexene on oxidation with KMnO4 and dilute H2SO4, then this gives adipic acid, or this is also known as hexane 1,6 dioic acid. Then see last preparation method, that is from Grignard's reagent or from dry ice or solid carbon dioxide. In this reaction, when Grignard's reagent is created with solid carbon dioxide in presence of dry ether, then this gives complex. And this complex on acid hydrolysis, then this gives carboxylic acid. See here example, this is a dry ice. This is a methyl magnesium bromide, is known as Grignard's reagent. This Grignard's reagent is created with solid carbon dioxide, or this is known as dry ice. In presence of dry ether, then this gives magnesium complex. In this reaction, this CH3 group is attached to this carbon atom, and here MgBr is attached to this oxygen atom, then this gives CH3C double bond OOMgBr. Means here double bond is converted to single bond, and we get here magnesium complex. And this magnesium complex on acid hydrolysis, then this gives acetic acid. Means in presence of acid, the water molecule is added to this complex, and this gives here CH3C double bond O, and this O and this H gives OH, means CH3COOH is known as acetic acid. And this OH group is attached to this magnesium to give here MgBrOH. Means here methyl magnesium bromide is created with solid carbon dioxide in presence of dry ether, then this gives magnesium complex. And this magnesium complex on acid hydrolysis, then this gives acetic acid. Now see another example, that is a phenyl magnesium bromide. This is a phenyl group. Phenyl magnesium bromide, when treated with dry ice, that is a solid carbon dioxide, in presence of dry ether, then this gives magnesium complex. In this reaction, this phenyl group is attached to this carbon atom, then this gives C6H5C double bond O, and this MgBr is attached to this oxygen atom, then double bond is converted to single bond, and we get here complex like C6H5C double bond O OMgBr. This is known as magnesium complex. Then this magnesium complex on acid hydrolysis, means this reacts with water in presence of dilute HCl, then this gives C6H5CO, this O and H, that is OH, means C6H5COOH, known as benzoic acid. And this OH group is attached to this magnesium atom to give MgBrOH. And we get here benzoic acid. Means phenyl magnesium bromide, that is Grignard's reagent, when treated with dry ice in presence of dry ether, then this gives complex. And this complex on acid hydrolysis, this gives benzoic acid. In this way, in today's lecture, we have completed the preparation of carboxylic acid. Thank you.